topic, data handling maps. In this chapter, we are going to see about what is data, types of graphs, pie chart, and some questions related to them. Now, let's see what is the data. The information collected in all such cases is called data. Now, types of graphs. First one is pictograph. Pictograph represents data through appropriate pictures. In pictographs, the same type of symbol is used to represent a certain value, and this is mentioned clearly in this graph. We have used the symbol to represent it. Now, question related to that. In class A, football is liked by 15 students, cricket is liked by 12 students, and swimming is liked by 15 students. And finally, 9 students like basketball. Now, show the data in pictograph. Now, let's use square to represent them. First, we will write for football. Football is liked by 15 students. So, we will use 3 tables for this. We will draw 5 squares. Now, next cricket is liked by 12 students. So, we should draw 4 squares. Now, next one is swimming, is liked by 15 students, same as football. Next one is 9 students is liked by basketball. So we should draw 3 squares. Now let's get into the next type of graphs. The second type is bar graph. A display is a display of information using bars of uniform width, their heights being proportional to the respective values. Here's an example of them. Apple, nicest fruit, apple. Apple is nearest to 30 and between 35. Now orange is between 30 and 25. Banana is between 10 and 15. Kiwi fruit is between 25 and 30. Blueberry is 40. Then grapes is 5. A question related to it. In a class 15 students like black, 14 students like red, 15 students like blue, and 5 like pink. Represent them in bar graph. Now 5 students like pink. So let's draw it first. Between 4 and 6. Now next we will draw 40 students liked by red. So let's draw that. Next one is 15 students is liked by black and 15 students likes blue. Now let's get into the next topic. The third type is double bar graph. A bar graph is showing two sets of data simultaneously. It is useful for the compensation of the data. There's a question related to it. In a class A, 30 students like South Indian food, 15 like North Indian food, 10 like Chinese. In class B, 25 like South Indian food, 20 like North Indian food, and 5 like Chinese. Represent in double bar graph. Now, first let's finish class A. 30 students like South Indian food. In class B, 25 like South Indian food. Next, 15 like North Indian food. In class B, 20 like North Indian food. Now in class A, 10 like Chinese. And in class B, 20, in class B, 5 like Chinese. Now let's get into the next topic, pie chart. These are called circle graphs. A circle graph shows the relation between a whole and its parts. Here the whole circle is divided into sectors. The size of each sector is proportional at the activity or information it represents. Now question related to it. The number of hours spent by a schoolboy on different activities in a working day is given below. Sleep 8 hours, sleeping 8 hours, school 7 hours, playing time 4 hours, homework time is 2 hours, other works 3 hours. Here I represented for 8 by 24 quarter hours in a day. So we should write the total here. 8 by 24 into 360 is equal to 120. 120 refers sleeping time. And 7 by 24 into 360 is 105. It's denoted as school. Now 4 by 24 into 360 is 60 for day time. By 24 into 360 is 30, and 3 by 24 into 360 is equal to 40.